Thank you for joining us for our scale queue demonstration series. Today we are going to examine the use of the unattended features of scale queue, as well as the use of the remote data terminal and remote printer. First, I'm going to go over the equipment we're going to be using in our demonstration. The first piece of equipment we are going to use is the remote data terminal, or RDT as we often refer to it. The RDT allows the driver to make data entry decisions about the transaction that is taking place, such as entering the truck number, the customer, the job, the material, or any other required information to complete the transaction. The next piece of equipment we are going to use is the remote printer. The remote printer can print multiple copies of the scale ticket and contain them in a ticket basket with a rubber rain flap, allowing for easy collection by the driver. Now I'm going to demonstrate how an unattended transaction is performed. First, the truck will board the scale. In this demonstration, I'm using a simulator. Next, the driver will enter his truck number. This can be accomplished by entering it on the keypad or by scanning a barcode or proximity card. In this case, I use a barcode. Next, the driver is prompted to select a piece of data for every required portion of the transaction. Notice that in this case, project and PO are not required portions of the transaction. These selections are made by using the keypad, either by direct code entry or by scrolling through available data to be selected. Once a driver has all required information selected, he is prompted to depart the scale to be loaded or unloaded, depending on application. Once the driver returns to the scale, he will again enter his truck number in the same manner that he previously did. Once the scale is settled, the transaction is complete, his tickets are printed and collected, and he is free to proceed off of the scale. If this were to be a single pass transaction using a stored tare weight, the second pass of the scale wouldn't have been required and the driver would have received his tickets at the end of the first weighment. That concludes our presentation today. Thank you for joining us, and please be on the lookout for more videos about ILS and Scale Queue.